Yeah, no, that's what you say, you're extra close.
But I'm always close to you. I'm always close. So now I'm in a little corner and I would be around. I brought my mom today because it's almost Mother's Day.
Oh, yay! Francis!
I will, and she won't let me cry on the phone with her, so she'll tell me to hang up and get my life together.
Okay, that's kind of tough. Okay. So when I told Durham today, Mommy's sick, he's like, do you want to cry? Not right now.
Not immediately.
Thanks for asking. Do you want to cry? Anyway, so anybody have any questions about important things, like what you're working on?
Hi, Kim.
Stacy has a question. Yes.
Okay, so this is kind of about the pre-writing stage and when you know you have a large idea to conquer or something, when something strikes you.
Right.
And it's actually for my thesis play that I'm going to write this thing, but it kind of wants me to write it now.
Okay.
If that makes any sense, it's like I wake up, I think about it. No, but I'm just, it's the play I know I want to write to work on for my thesis play.
It's supposed to happen
over the course of this next year in school.
Okay.
But it kind of wants to be written now.
Okay.
And I'm afraid of, like, I'm doing things to sate that desire to write it, like doing research for it and reading things, and it's only making me want to write it even more, even though it's giving me information that I kind of need for it. So it's like,
you know what I'm gonna ask you? Go ahead.
I guess what I want to know is when it feels like a big idea, how do you like temper that and not let the fact, like not let everything come in and just keep it about the story you want to tell instead of all the ideas that you have and then suddenly let it write itself?
So Stacy has a play that you should be in your program, you should be starting out in the fall. Is that correct? Okay. But she says it wants to be written now. And there are two questions actually, so what do you do about that? I should be starting it in September, but what's going to be now? And there are a lot of big ideas. How do I sort of just keep focus on the play, the story, right? So my question about wanting to write the play now, do you have other things you should be working on now?
Everything's kind of wrapping itself up, so I can redraft stuff.
Do you have something you're supposed to be working on now?
No, actually, no? Everything's kind of...
So, yes. So, until the timing, I don't see the problem.
Yeah. Timing-wise,
Okay. So, it wants to be written now. That's
yeah,
the,
like,
that's
off, like my deadlines are all done.
Okay. So, it's not like... It wants to be written now, so... That's not an issue. Okay, so that's really helpful. Okay. Just because your professor might say start in September, that's... So this is September, really. So how do you keep it just confined to what it's about and not the big ideas?
Yeah.
What do you mean specifically? Is there a way you're talking about it?
Sometimes I'll come at a play first, like I'll know thematically what I want to write about. And the things will kind of either it'll come up in the book. It's like the topic, the subject matter will find me before even characters do sometimes. And then once I sit down though, like what'll usually happen is that when I have this happen, I'll have a moleskin and I'll be on the train and then I'll just start writing stuff and the characters will get it. So I'm worried about me kind of still keeping the fire, and I know it's just showing up in writing, so I'm not afraid of it not being able to get written. But I don't want it to be about themes, and not story. Like, I don't want to get people in the themes. I really want those things to kind of come out of Catherine's story rather than the way it feels like it's trying to come theme to character, which kind of feels lopsided to me.
Do you know who your characters are?
I know there are several through lines together, and I know like this one through line, there's three characters, I know them. I've written them actually already, so they're reprising. And then they're in a short that I'm now in. So I know those three folks.
Right.
And I actually know their story arc. Like I know how their story ends. And so the stories I'm going to weave in, I have general ideas of who I, it's satire, so it's not like these really rich characters, more than they're kind of Brechtian, kind of stocky, other courage-y characters. But even those characters are really
I would say so. Yeah. So I just would say stick to the characters, you know. I mean, so because what you were saying before is kind of like, you know, I'll just do research instead of writing it. That doesn't make any sense because you can't write it now, right? And I would just focus on the characters as much as you can.
Okay.
And not so focused on the talking points about the book.
Yes, exactly what I mean.
Yeah. I would say focus on the characters. You know, the three characters, what about the other ones? Just because it's satire doesn't mean they can't be.
Right, rich characters.
Yeah. You already know.
Yeah, so just, I'll play with them maybe some and see what happens.
See, you know what you're doing.
I have to say it out loud sometimes.
I know, well, that's good. That's good. Anybody else? Yes.
Hi.
Remind me of your name, so I can space it on it.
I'm Julia.
Julia?
Yes.
Julia, okay.
I'm actually having a similar problem. And I was wondering if you had any like exercises to help keep you focused on the characters that you particularly liked.
So Julia's writing a play. She has a similar thing going on with Stacey. And do I have any exercises to keep focused on what?
On the character? Like to, you know, to kind of help you stay focused on the character?
Right. Do you do those character bio things?
I haven't.
Character biography? I mean, the reason why I'm slow to sort of suggest a character biography is that so many times I hear writers say, and I read their play or talk about their play in class or whatever, and I'm like, this character really isn't here. What about specific things? And they're like, oh, I know all that. I wrote the biography. You know, and none of it gets into play. So there's kind of a disconnect between getting the character biography and getting the biography in the play. You can spend time, I mean, do a biography and see if that helps you stay focused on the character. That's something to do. And it's up to you to figure out, you know, I'm going to connect these things I'm discovering to the action of a play. You know, because people do a whole biography of a character, and then the play will be about issues. And they're like, I know all these personal things about them. So, give that a try. Spend more time with the characters. If you know the plot, if you know what happens to them, focus on what they want, why they want it, how they go about getting it, things like that too. That's really interesting. So it's not so much about, you know, what's their favorite color, or are they Scorpio or Gemini. Yeah, I know, right. And if people think like they write 20 pages of, he's a Scorpio with the whatever rising, and that means blah blah blah.
When you put them in a situation, like you just, even if it's not in your play, give them a situation, and that helps me when I work on character stuff that way.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh,
you do?
Kind of, I don't. know how to phrase it very well. I have two different things that I want to develop. I have the same problem. And that's, they're very comical and like kind of almost a cartoony kind of humor.
Right.
But they have really dark, sad, bittersweet endings.
Right.
And I'm trying to blend the two well, but I'm a little bit afraid that with both of them, they're going to feel kind of a bait and switch in the beginning when everything's all jovial and comical, and then it's really dark and depressing at the end.
Right.
So how is the best way to kind of make those two non-cohesive genres a bit more cohesive?
I see that as a problem. You know what I mean? I think that's just the story that you're telling. You know, you think, the first thing you think about is a zoo story, you know? There's two guys on the bench or whatever, however the play goes, and they're both sad. So I think that you can write what you want to write, and if people really get angry and start throwing things because they feel like they've been lied to, they're told it's comedy, and then sad, you know, the sadness. And hopefully there's sort of, you'll feel the clouds gathering on your landscape, you know what I mean? And your sad thing is just gratuitous, like sadness, you know? So hopefully you'll see the clouds approaching in, you know, one way or another. They always do. So look in the sky, like, you know, have your characters look up and see, oh, there's a cloud. Maybe I haven't talked about that yet. There's a moment of sort of, not foreshadowing, that would be kind of cheesy, but the idea that, you know, darkness might be avoidable, but you know, the possibility of what. Does that make sense?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so look in the sky, look and see if you can see anything that you might have missed. You know, to sort of give us a little nudge, make us a little unsettled, so that when the end comes, you're like, oh, wow, yeah, I got it. It's a little weird, huh? That makes sense. You know, maybe it's like candy. want the first one. You don't want that one.
Yeah.
I don't worry about it too much. It's okay. Yeah, yeah. I know. It's hard. But, you know, it's just, it's a practice. So, you know, it's okay not to like it. I don't know why in specific, so, you know, what it is. But it's probably just like, okay, I can do better than that. Maybe I'll do better than that with this, or I'll do better than that on my next one. You know. But, the goal is to keep, and then maybe after you finish the other one, we can go back and go, oh, no, this is happening. And then we, I do get next course. Anybody else? No? Oh, yes.
Don't even worry, they're so inexpensive. I mean...